Welcome to this new video. In this video, I'm going to be talking about the SV Boney SV555 refractor. It's an apochromatic mini compact refractor with a focal length of 243 millimeters, which means it's suitable for wide field astrophotography, and it's also suitable for capturing targets like comets. It has a variable aperture of f5.6 to f22, so it's good for astrophotography and it's also good for daytime photography. It's a manual lens, so if you use it for daytime photography, you're gonna need to place it on a tripod. The refractor is a Petzval refractor, has five elements, and this means that it has a self-flattening design. So it delivers sharp stars all across your image without needing a field flattener. Its optical components have very good illumination, and it can also accommodate a full-frame camera as well as a crop sensor camera. In my video, I'll be using a crop sensor camera because I do not have a full frame camera. The video will be divided into four parts. The first part is we're gonna unbox the refractor and see what's in the box. The second part is installing the focuser. If you're interested to see how I installed the focuser, easy process. The third part is we're gonna go over the mechanical aspects of the refractor. And the fourth part will be going over the performance of the refractor and check a couple images that I captured with the refractor and judging the quality of the stars and the performance. So grab a cup of tea or coffee and enjoy the video. All right, let's go over the unboxing of the optical tube assembly. This is the box. I'm gonna remove the top part. And this is how the box comes with the contents. This is the manual here. This is the optical tube case. And this is the optical tube. Here we have an extension piece which goes on the Vixen plate. This will create room for the focuser. I'll show you in a second. We have this small baggie that has Allen wrenches, screws. This is the focuser accessories, the belt and the bolt here, the tube ring, this is the focuser bracket, this is the top holding bracket, and this is the Vixen plate. So this is all what comes in the box. What I'm gonna show you next is how to assemble the optical tube and put the focuser on. So the first thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put the optical tube with the optical tube ring. So it's gonna go like this. And we're gonna place the screw here. You wanna make sure this is tight. Okay, so it looks pretty tight. And if you are not going to use an autofocuser, you can directly place the Vixen plate like this here, using those screws. Or if you wanna put the focuser, you will have to put this extension piece like that. And basically this is going to create the room for the autofocuser to go on here. So I'm going to do that. I'm going to install this piece and the Vixen plate from the get-go. So basically we're going to put them together like this. Now for this part, you're going to use these two screws here. The longer screws that you have here, and you're gonna place these screws and you're gonna use this Allen wrench to to tighten them. Okay, so I'm gonna place this like that, and just I'm gonna tighten this slightly with my finger. Sorry about the noise. Okay, now the extension part is installed with the Vixen plate. I'm gonna put this aside here. The next part is going to be putting the focuser on. And this can be slightly tricky, but I will break it down into easier parts for you. So this is the belt. So the first thing you're gonna do is you wanna remove the focusing screw, the screw that locks the focuser. First thing you're gonna do is remove that completely. Put that aside. Then go ahead and put your belt on like that. Just position it roughly here. Okay. And then you have this bolt and these two black screws. So you're gonna get those out. And here I have this mini Allen wrench, and it did not come with the tube. Maybe SVBoni will provide that in other samples, but you want to put the those tiny screws on like this, and I'm gonna just slightly insert it in the two holes inside this bolt like this, in a way that they don't show from the inside. So I put the first one here, and then I'm gonna put the second small screw like this here. Just place it a little bit inside. Then you're gonna place this on the focuser. Now, as for the focuser has a flat end on its axis. So one of the screws should meet this end here. So I'm gonna place it, position it like that. Then I'm gonna tighten this. So basically it is secure, and I'm gonna tighten the second screw as well. So here we have this bolt is secure on the focuser. I'm gonna make sure it's tight enough. You don't wanna over tighten it because you can break the Allen wrench or the screw inside. So you don't wanna do that. Just make sure it is tight. I use this force like this. Okay, now we got that on. The next part is you're gonna put the focuser on the bracket like that. Okay, and you're gonna use two small screws here. So there are two tiny M4 or M3, like the small screws that come here. So those two small screws, so you're gonna use that, and you're gonna use this Allen wrench with it, and you are going to place these screws on. And the second screw, like that. You just place them on. You don't have to tighten it, just a little bit, just to put it in place, because this will need to move like that. And then once you have this done, you're gonna get the M6 screws, the short M6 screws that come with this. So the shortest, thickest screws, you're gonna go ahead, you're gonna position this tentatively here, put the belt on just to position it. Okay, and here, it looks like it's gonna be somewhere like this here. So I'm gonna position the focuser bracket like that, and I'll just tighten this screw. I'm gonna get the thicker Allen wrench, just position the bracket so it's in a good position like this. So that seems pretty good. I'm gonna get the second screw, place it on like this, and just tighten. So you see the bracket is pretty, the bracket is pretty close and secure to the Vixen plate. Okay, now we got that. The next part is just position the belt properly like this, and you see the belt is in a pretty good position here. So what you're gonna do, I'm gonna flip this over, and you see now the focuser is in a great spot. Now while I'm pushing down, I'm gonna get my Allen wrench and I'm gonna tighten these two screws. So this is pretty good. So the belt is pretty is tight enough, but it doesn't need to be super tight. And you just go ahead and tighten those small screws like this. And I want to make sure this is tight. And here you have it. Oh, it moved a little bit, but really it's not a big deal. If this is an issue, you can just loosen this slightly and just move the bracket a little bit forward to the front. Once you're done, tighten it again. Now, if it moves a little bit, it's okay because the belt has teeth that engages in the ring, so it's really not a big issue. You're not going to war with this, so as long as it's stable here, you are okay. The next part is put the holding bracket on top, which is easy, pretty straightforward. You're gonna get two of those regular screws here, this and this. And you know, you can put four screws, but I'm just gonna use two. Really, I don't think I need more, because usually it's just the guiding scope that goes here. So okay, and here is the tube assembled with the autofocuser. Now right here in the back, this is a 48 millimeter cap. Now you can remove that if you want. The thing here is, for the filter here, you have to remove those screws right here. You will remove it, you will take this part out. On the inside there is a 48 millimeter socket, so where you will install the filter, and you will put this back, put these screws back. So this is if you want to put a filter here. Now I have a workaround. I have a 50 millimeter extension tube, and I have a camera here, and I have a filter drawer. So basically I can be using this filter drawer, and I can be using these extension tubes like this. So this is 50 millimeters, this is 20 millimeters, and this is 20. So basically right now I have 55 millimeters of back focus here, and I can place the camera here in the back. And now I have my camera, my filter drawer that I can take in and out, and the 50 millimeters. So this is just one suggestion to make your life easier, really, if you want to put a filter on down the road. And also always make sure you have 35 millimeters between the camera and the this part right here. So with this, you have about 55 millimeters of back focus. So this is the camera installed. And as you can see right here, the rig is now ready for imaging.
All right, now let's go over the mechanical specifications of the refractor. Now, this is the refractor in front of me, already installed with all the components, the focuser, and it's sitting on a ZWO AM5 mount. The refractor has a dew shield that is removable, and this is the dust cap. And you can see here the lens, and this is the aperture variation. You can see this is the F22, and this is the F 4.5. I'm gonna be using it with the wide aperture here. This right here is the focusing ring, and this is the focuser belt. There's a slight wiggle here, but it's okay because the belt has teeth that are engaged to the ring itself. This is a small guiding scope here. And this right here is the rotator. So basically, if you loosen this screw, you can rotate and you can tighten when you're done here. This is the tube ring. And very important here, I have this. This is a 5 millimeter piece, and this is a 10 millimeter piece. So this is a 15, and this is a 20. So this is a 35 millimeter back focus. This is very important because I was not able to achieve the focus without getting exactly 35 millimeters. Now, one thing here, this piece right here has a holder for your filter. However, I got a filter drawer here and I actually made it easier for me. So just a suggestion or a solution for you, if you wanna make the filter removal easier, I got this drawer, and I have the link in the description of the video. And this is my camera here installed and ready to go. This is my ASI Air, and basically this is the complete rig right here, and it's ready for imaging. And I'll see you in the next part of the video. Welcome back. Now let's look at the performance of the SV555. A little bit of a background, SV Boney did have a problem with the initial version of this refractor. It had an issue of pinched stars that Trevor and other YouTubers discussed in their videos. However, SV Boney was made aware of the problem and they fixed the issue, not only in the new sample that they sent me, they also fixed it with all the other future samples that they are going to introduce into the market. So the issue of pinched stars is completely gone. And as you can see here, the stars are perfect and the performance of this telescope is exceptional. I went to a dark site and I took the setup with me. I captured the Jellyfish Nebula and the California Nebula using my 2600 MC Pro camera. And I was using the Optolong L Ultimate filter, which filters the oxygen and hydrogen alpha. And as you can see the images here, the performance of this refractor is exceptional. And definitely for the price and the performance, I don't think any other brands will be able to beat that. And I hope you found this video useful. If you did, please don't forget to like and subscribe, and clear skies.